was down by Brannigan's corner, one morning I did stray. I met a fellow rebel, and to me he did say, he had orders from our captain to assemble at Dunbar. But how are we to get there without a motor car? Oh Barney, dear, be of good cheer, I'll tell you what you'll do. The specials, they are plentiful, but the IRA are few. We'll send a wire to Johnson to meet us at Stranlar, and we'll give the boys a jolly good drive in Johnson's motor car. Dr. Johnson heard the news, he soon put on his shoes. He said, this is an urgent case, there is no time to lose. He then put on his caster hat and on his breast a star. You could hear the din go through Glenfinn of Johnson's motor car. But when he got to the railway bridge, the rebels he saw there. Old Johnson knew the game was up, for at him they did stare. He said, I have a permit to travel near or far. To hell with your English permit, we want your motor car. What will my loyal brethren think whene'er they hear the news? My car it has been commandeered by the rebels at Dunluce. We'll give you a receipt for it, all signed by Captain Barr. And when Ireland gets their freedom by, you'll get your motor car. Well, they put that car in motion and filled it to the brim, with guns and bayonets shining that made old Johnson grim. Then Barney hoisted a Sinn Féin flag and it fluttered like a star, and we gave three cheers for the IRA and Johnson's motor car.